Start streaming. What's up? How's everybody doing today? I'm gonna do another stream about another one of my favorite bands. So I was trying to decide today if I was gonna talk about there's a couple different topics on Alice in Chains I've wanted to cover. But before I start, the discount code for today's live stream, which I usually forget to do, is RB500. It's 50% off all my my educational things. My Beato ear training, which is a killer deal. My Beato book and my quick lessons guitar course, which for this is the time to get them. If you're interested in doing it, I didn't do a sale last week. For those of you that watch my new video on the band Muddy Magnolias, the song, that was a really unexpected video. It's very cool. A lot of people watched it. If you haven't watched it, you should check it out. I kind of talked about what it means to be an artist. So, and I have more to say on that in a future videos. I have another kind of interesting video about that. Okay, there's two Alice in Chains videos I wanted to make, but I want to talk about what I think is the quintessential Alice in Chains song. Now, Billy and I were talking about this earlier. You guys know that I'm a massive grunge fan, okay? People are sick of grunge. People that watch my channel know that I love grunge, okay? I'm never going to stop talking about grunge. Alice in Chains, though, is the band I always come back to. As much of a fan of all the bands that I like, and I don't know why, the darkness of it, the unusual phrasing that Lane Staley had, the blend of Jerry's and Lane's voice together, the great kind of harmonic sounds that they put together, the heaviness of the guitar sounds, the heaviness of the grooves, the unique bass vibes, bass licks, and so many of the songs, right? So I just did a comparison between the top songs on Apple Music Apple Music and the top songs on Spotify, okay? Just out of curiosity to see. The top songs, top five on Spotify are Man in a Box, Wood, Nutshell, Rooster, Them Bones, Down in a Hole, No Excuses. Okay, I went more than five. And then Apple Music is Rooster, Wood, Nutshell, Man in a Box. Where does it go after that, Billy?
Goes to Man in a Box.
Then Man in a Box, Down in a Hole, Them Bones, No Excuses. It's interesting because it's all the same songs, but they're just mixed up in the amount of plays, right? In which songs are the biggest on each platform. But it's all the same songs. Now, I will say this. There's a record that does not get its due. And I want to mention it up front so I don't forget. Black Gives Way to Blue, which came out in 2009. And I love that record. The first track on it is really, I mean, it's one of the best sounding rock records. I was actually just talking to my dear friend Phil X about this particular record. And the first song is All Secrets Known. And I want to do a video on that at some point because that song, that whole record sounds phenomenal. And that's William Duvall's first record as a singer. Nick Rasculin has produced it and Randy Staub mixed it. And I just wanted to give it a shout out because it's really outstanding, especially for, you know, the first record back. And for those of you that are Alice in Chains fans, I've mentioned it before on here. Go watch the studio videos that they made way back in 2009 that they put on YouTube. There's a 12-part series, And it's really great in the of the making of the record, because you get to see what amplifiers they use. You see how they track the drums. It's really, really well done, right? It's for a producer guy like me, this is the stuff I want to see, right? It's like the behind the scenes, how they record his stuff. Okay. All right. So let me talk about when I talk about songs here. Let's just play a couple things now. So now, Them Bones, I did a What Makes This Song Great about. It's one of my earliest ones. To me, it's one of the greatest opening tracks on a record. It's the opening track on Dirt. It always scares the hell out of me when it comes in. The first scream that that Lane does really scares me, and it is so heavy. Okay, so that song was in the running. The next song that was in the running to me that's an outstanding song is Wood. Now, Wood has such a unique bass line to it. Has a great groove. I love all the guitar work in the verses. I love the snare. It's massive. So the dynamics. But to me, the strongest part of this song, the verse is incredible. Another thing that makes this song unreal is the chorus. Right here. Oh. That line, the second half of the chorus, is so powerful. Let's hear the whole chorus. Right here. Oh, but this one, when he goes up higher. And it's a perfect melody. The shape of the melody is absolutely perfect. And the transition from the chorus to the verse is unbelievable. Okay, so that one, there's no weakness in that song, right? Another song that is outstanding is this. This is, to me, this was in my top 20 acoustic intros video, which is my biggest video on my channel. And this is the best intro of an Alice in Chains song. So it's so moody, so beautiful, and it sounds like grunge. And it doesn't need the heavy guitars to have the intensity, but it doesn't have the chorus. That's the only thing about I Stay Away, that the chorus is not as great. It's not in the same league as Wood, for example. Man in the Box. Okay. Okay, Man in the Box. When I think about Man in the Box, I like the verse. It's okay. But the chorus is amazing, right? And I listen to these songs forever. But to me, the chorus is the outstanding part of this song. So I'm thinking, like, what is the song? Which one of these has it all the way through? The verse, the chorus, everything. Well, I'll tell you one that really is outstanding. Down in a Hole. Ooh. it really blends the elements. The chorus guitars, the cool groove with all the space, the great snare sound. Halftime. This has a great verse, a great chorus. Amazing chorus, so moody. But I don't think that that's their greatest song. But that's an incredibly great song, right? Some people might say that
I'm beside you, like the coldest winter well. Heaven beside you.
Now, Heaven Beside You is, I love Heaven Beside You, but is that really a quintessential Alice in Chains song? No, to me it's not. No Excuses. Killer song. Okay. Now, the one thing about this song that does that keeps it off there is, and this is the one of the only songs of Alice in Chains, this particular album is very, this is a technical thing, it's very compressed sounding to me. If you listen to it when it comes in, it's so squished. It makes it very flat. It doesn't have the dynamics of the other songs, right? It's literally just kind of like this. That snare is as loud as it's gonna get.
It's all right. There comes a time.
Got no- okay, so. So that leaves one song here. I think it's really between two songs. I think this is Alice in Chains' greatest song. Because this has everything an Alice in Chains song needs. Space, cool flanging, great harmonies, a killer bass line that's way out front, those open chords that are so moody. Phenomenal vocal performance.
Seems every path leads me to nowhere.
Oh, man. I love the fading in and out of that lead guitar, too. With the wah-wah. Oh, man.
Bullet streams to me from sight.
Oh. Oh, so good. Now, okay, like everything about this, the bass line is improvised, the lead into it, the way the chorus explodes. Come the rooster, yeah. You know we ain't gonna die. Oh man. Amazing riff. And then the post-chorus interlude riff is just as good, right? Oh, man. Okay, so we're 3 minutes into the song and we've just done one chorus. You hear how it speeds up there? The songs breathe. The song has so much space in it. It changes tempos. But the thing that's so great about it is that the lyrics are actually about something. And this is the, Jerry wrote this for, it's talking about his dad who fought in Vietnam. And I was thinking about most of these songs that I talk about nowadays, when I do these top 10 countdowns and stuff, it doesn't matter whether it's the pop charts, the rock charts, the metal charts. None of these songs are about anything, or many of them are not about anything. And that's really the thing I think that makes me be so disconnected from some contemporary music is like writing songs that are about things, right? About experiences. So I would say that that it's between Rooster. I gotta remind people that are just joining. I have to do my ad here, 50% off everything in my store, my Beato book, my ear training program, and my guitar, Quick Lessons Pro guitar course. If you were going to buy them, if you want to help yourself improve as a musician, be able to figure out songs by ear, learn music theory, or get better on the guitar, and support the channel so I can keep making videos like this, RB500 is the discount code. So Aaron is posting it here in the chat. The other song that to me is the one to choose between the two is Them Bones.
Some say
This wastes no time. When the guitars go open here, okay, to me, Them Bones is just hits right from the top, right? So there's two types of Alice in Chains songs. There's ones that just, this goes for the throat, right? Right off the bat. You got the odd time signature. You got the heavy guitar right in from the downbeat with a, with a scream right into it. Get the harmonies out front. It's a short verse and it's into an amazing chorus, right? And it's so heavy. I mean, it's dark, it's heavy. It starts off that record, starts off Dirt. And it, once again, it's the quintessential grunge song. You know when I said, like, I Stay Away has that sound, that openness, the droning. So you have the droning Alice in Chains, which is Rooster, you know, which is Down in a Hole, which is the wood things that with the kind of droning sounds in the verse with a great riff. When I hear wood, Wood as the sound is also the sound of Seattle. Wood as the sound of when I hear that, it's like, yeah, Pearl Jam, Soundgarden, Temple of the Dog, Alice in Chains, especially the groove. The groove is a quintessential kind of Seattle. That is really like a Seattle groove. That is a Seattle sound. That is kind of a combination, right? That's got the moody verse, the moody reverbed out vocals and stuff, and that has an amazing chorus. To me, those three songs, Wood, Rooster, and Them Bones, if I had to pick one of those to listen to, of all three of those, I don't know if I could. Billy, what do you think?
I like all three of those, but I love Heaven Beside You a lot too. I listened to Rooster earlier though.
I don't know if I could, I don't know if I could pick between those three. I think all three of those songs are perfect songs. They really are. Those are the three best. Those are the three best Alice in Chains songs, I think. If you were to say what is the best sounding Alice in Chains song, then I would go with this. I would go to the one I was talking about earlier, which is where is it here? Discography. See all here. The God, I hate how they do this. This All Secrets Known. This to me is one of the best sounding rock songs ever. Let's just listen to it. Oh man. Then listen to the drums. Listen to those guitars. Wow. Ben. Guitars. Man. That's the best sounding Alice in Chains song. No question. I think that's the best sounding rock song that's come out. That's one of the best sounding rock songs I've ever heard. The sound of it. Man, it is just crushing. If you were to say, hey, what's the best sounding, the heaviest sounding rock song? Yeah, that song is one of the first things that comes to mind right there. That record is unreal. And the thing I like about it, about that song, I mean, this whole record, but that song is that has multiple layers of heavy guitars, but there's so much definition to them. Everything is, it's called All Secrets Known. It's the first song off Black Gives Way to Blue, which came out in 2009. That's with the singer William Duvall. I mean, that's really Jerry singing that. And that blows me away. That is, when I heard that record, every song on it is phenomenal. This is the record that I said, there are YouTube videos on the making of this record. And if you like guitar sounds and you like recording and production of rock, this is, they go through and they show the making of this. They show doing the, they show how they tracked it and what amps they used and how they tracked the drums, how they tracked the bass. It's really, it's very, very, very cool. But if we're talking about the greatest Alice in Chains songs, it's Wood, it is Them Bones, and which one's yours, Billy? What's your favorite one?
Oh, man. I love Rooster, but I also love Heaven Beside You a lot.
Rooster, and Billy gives one vote for Heaven Beside You. Heaven Beside You is just so, it's too out in left field for me that it doesn't, I like it, but it's not moody. It doesn't have the moody vibe of Alice in Chains. Alice in Chains has to be dark. It really does. I love Down in a Hole. I see Down in a Hole. I see a bunch of votes for Down in a Hole. Nutshell is a killer song as well. That's Nutshell is on Before I Stay Away. That's the song before it. And Nutshell is a great song as well. That's an incredible 1-2 punch on, what is that, on Jar of Flies, right? Those two songs? Yeah. 1994. Those two songs are incredibly good back to back. I love Nutshell, the kind of the use of the open chords tuned down. Really, really outstanding. But Alice in Chains needs to be dark. It does. So that's why I keep coming back to Rooster, to Them Bones, to Wood. Those songs are really dark songs. Down in a Hole, great songs. But if you were to pin me down, I don't know, I'd probably say Wood. Because that to me is just an incredible chorus on it. So anyways, that's my take on that. Massively big Alice in Chains fan. I will always devote time to talking about grunge on my channel. I've done many, many videos on it. You guys are incredible. Discount code for today's live stream is RB500. It's 50% off everything. My ear training course, my Beato book, and my Quick Lessons Pro. If you wanted to get any of those, this is the time to get them. It makes you a better musician, and they help support the channel. I didn't answer all the top chats. I did look at them. Thank you so much for that. I can't get to them right now. Otherwise, I would answer them. I'm not sure how to get to them, to answer them. But I will go back and look at the stream and answer them in the comment section afterwards. How's that? You guys are awesome. Have a great, great weekend. And Billy, you got anything else to say?
Not really, except I love Alice in Chains.
Billy loves Alice in Chains. We listened to the new Foo Fighters record today. But we're not through the whole thing yet. But we got 3/4 of the way through. Check out the new Animals as Leaders record. It is killer. I'm going to be interviewing Tosin about it coming up. Just talked to him a bit ago. But if you get a chance, check out the new Animals as Leaders. It's really outstanding. You guys are fantastic. We will talk later. Have a great, great weekend. Bye-bye.